Welcome to this The Tech Geeks video. What do I need to run Unifi Express? This one video I'm really excited about because it's something that I think fits a space that Ubiquiti hasn't totally operated in before. We have had the Amplify range from Ubiquiti. So we've had the Amplify HD, we've got the Alien HD, but it never fitted into the Ubiquiti UniFi range. So it sort of separated it from it. What we're now seeing with UniFi Express, this is the little device here, is that coming to the UniFi range. So let's talk a little bit about what is UniFi Express. If you've seen any of our other videos on what do I need to run UniFi Network or Ubiquiti UniFi Network, then you'll realize there are some key components that you need to be able to run a Ubiquiti network. You need the controller. It's often called an OS console. It's the software that you can install on your phone, the software you can install on your computer, or you buy something like the UDMSE or the CloudKey Gen 2 Plus, and the operating system runs on there. If you've ever installed the software on your phone or on your computer and you lose that computer or you get it damaged or you've never taken a backup, then your only option is to go and factory reset all of the equipment to get it working again. We also miss the ease of setup. So what does UniFi Express do? Well, it actually brings all of those components into this one device. A UniFi Express, this the product code UX, is a wireless 6 access point. It's a 2x2 access point. So speed tests or so we've done on this, probably, I mean, there are ways to optimize these to get the best performance out of them by binding extra channels together or whatever. But out of the box, this probably does around about 300 megasecond for wireless. Remember, it's only 2x2, so that is some of the limiter. Your device may be able to get it faster. If you optimize the network, like I said, put the channel bandwidth wider, then you'll probably get better performance, but just out of the box. We can get at least 500 megasecond on an internet connection. So that should be good for your Starlinks or your NBN fiber and those type of things. I would think it probably will do around about 700 or 800 megasecond quite comfortably, but we could only test it to 500 meg. So you get the wireless access point in there, you get a router built into here, and then the most important thing that makes this super easy is you get a small cut down version of the Ubiquiti UniFi network controller. It can manage a total of 5 devices. Those could be other access points, those could be more of these UniFi Express, they could be Ubiquiti switches. So now what we've got is a product that fits into this simple to set up market space, and we can start to build our Ubiquiti network as we go along. So how do we use this and how do we set this up? Well, to start with, we need to create an account at unifi.ui.com, just remembering to get that right. All right, that's where your controller is going to be housed. You can then remotely, as long as it's got an internet connection, you can remotely access that from anywhere in the world and you get a whole bunch of statistics, who's online, you can change your config and everything else. So I'm just gonna pop onto my phone here now. All right, we're gonna take one of these devices and plug it in to the mains. So I have a couple of set up on the bench here that you won't be able to see, but we'll show you what's happening on the screen as we go along. So this has been plugged in and you'll actually start to see as it boots, it'll actually start to show on the front of the screen here that it's booting. Now they do take 4 or 5 minutes to start, so it does take a little bit of time to go. So firstly, go and you log into your, or download onto your phone, the Ubiquiti UniFi Network app, and log in to your account onto that device. Now I have several other devices set up on here. So you'll see me just show you that what I've logged in as, and you can see here on the screen that I can actually choose which controller I'm talking to. So I'm then going to, from this, click on, or once this unit's started up, you'll see that what happens on the screen is it pops up to say it has found a new device. Make sure you have got an internet connection plugged in. So that's gonna go into the port here with a little world symbol on it. All right, so you need to be plugged into an internet connection. All right, and let that continue booting. You'll still see on the front of the screen here, it's showing you that it boots. Mine takes 4 or 5 minutes, so we're not gonna sit here and wait for all of that. We will speed through. Once it's actually got to the point, so I'm just getting there on the screen here. Once it's actually got there, it should now say that it's found it and it's ready to connect, and it will go through and start connecting. This is now where some of the magic happens. We now have the option to choose how we're going to set this up. So in our instance, we don't have any other Unifi controller in the network, so we're going to set this up as a new controller. So choose that option and let it go through. It wants to choose a Wi-Fi network, so we'll call it the Tech Geeks. All right, and I'll just set the password as the Tech Geeks. All right, and we'll let that go through, because remember, it's going to do your access point. So it's now going to connect, and it wants us now to connect to that Wi-Fi connection that we've just created. And so it's going to take my device off and connect to it. It's going to tell me a whole load of bits and pieces that are going on that I'm really excited about, maybe. All right. Now, I found after it had connected and finished up that my app actually crashed. So hopefully yours won't at that point. All I needed to do was actually just restart the app, and I was able to log in. So let me just wait a moment while that gets itself. There you can see it's now connected and it's joining the network, and it's told me it's connected to the Wi-Fi. So I can actually get internet access now. It's already giving me all of those details out. All right, and so let me just go back through. As you can see, my app crashed, so I'm just restart my app. And it gives me that option, do I wanna connect to the console directly or over the internet? And that will be something that will change depending on location. Because I'm in the same network, I'm gonna connect to it locally. You can now see that if I had multiple controllers, I could edit them and see them from that. And it's showing me what's going on. It's already worked out that I'm on Aussie broadband. And now I can go into some of the settings. I'm not going to give you an in-depth into all of these, but you can change the name of the device in here. You can see the channel widths that we've got. We've just set these at 40, HE 40. If you wanted to try pushing that up higher, maybe to HE 80, you'll get faster Wi-Fi speeds, but over a shorter distance. So you can do lots of control in there for that type of thing. You can do channel optimization. As you can see, I can set the channel widths to what I want them to be. So there are a few bits in there that are useful. Now, once we have got through some of those basics, which I'll let run through on the screen here, whichever side it is, so you can actually see. You can see we get this Wi-Fi experience. We can see what applications are running through, how many users. We can go into Wi-Fi here and add a new Wi-Fi or change the Wi-Fi settings. We can make the SSID just appear on one access point or on others. So let me just show you those few bits. We can go in here now and change our IP range if we want to. All right, we can go into gateway IP subnet there up the top. And if we go into that option there, we can turn off auto scale, and we can set our IP addresses how we want them to be in there. So you may choose the default, but that should give you a good starting point. Now, what do we want to do if we want to add another one of these? That's where it gets interesting. What is the whole point of this? The idea is that we can add multiple of these together to create a mesh network. So we've got two of them here. This one's maybe connected to our internet, and maybe we're now going to put this somewhere else in the house. Look, the testing on these, we can get probably about 300 megasecond in some basic testings just out the box for the wireless. Remember that each repeat that you go through will physically halve the speed, and especially because this is a 2x2 wireless, it will run into some performance issues. So let me give you an idea. At about 12 meters, through three concrete walls, all right, if we're just running one of these devices, we'll be dropping down to about 30 megasecond, which is still pretty acceptable. If we put two of these like this together at that same distance, then obviously my wireless device, my phone or whatever, will now connect to the closest one, and then these two devices talk to each other. That can give us, again, a speed of maybe 80 or 90 megaseconds, so a faster speed at that point. So we do see a step up in performance by meshing these together, but we wouldn't want to suggest that you put those more than maybe 10 meters apart. The idea is to get Wi-Fi in a greater density than greater distance. The key we have and to remember in this is that you want to keep devices as close as possible to this, because an access point can't keep a track of all the different speeds that of all the different devices. So if we've got one device, a phone or something like that, a long way away, it will start to drop the speed down for everybody else connected. So you want to spread these out. So we can then continue in our app here. All right, so I'll just carry on my phone. And so we can power up our second device. And once our second device starts to power up, we go through the same process. It says, hey, I found a new device. We're going to need to wait that 3 or 4 minutes, so we will speed through that little bit for you. And the great thing now you can see is it's going to ask us, as we're going through, how do you want to set this up? So we want to now add this to a current system. So once we have then added it to our current system, it will now become another device. Notice we didn't need to wire this in place to actually make it work. All right, it was happy at the point that it could see the other device and it was actually able to connect to it. And so we can again obviously give it a name. I suggest that you maybe call it a mesh or another device so you know where you're actually going to put it in that other location. And then you can start to spread these out. Remember, you can use the LAN cable on here if you want to be able to connect other devices to it in your other location. And you just spread these out. So maybe you've got this set up and you've got it in a mesh and you decided you want to actually add another physical access point, maybe something like this. This is old Ubiquiti AC Pro, but you probably go for something like a U6 Lite or a U6 Pro. Then you can do that same function. You probably need to have a switch or a PoE injector, and it's going to be plugged into your LAN port of your main device. Your LAN port there of your main device can now go out to a switch or something like that. And again, we can follow in here the same process that we have done before. So as you'll see that once it's been plugged in, our other device will appear waiting to be adopted, and we can go in, adopt the unit, all right, and this will now add it to our network. And we've now got three managed Ubiquiti devices. So remember, we've got a maximum of five that we can use to make this all work. So that should give us an idea of all the different options that we've got. Let me just go through here. I can show you in here that in this instance, like my adoption failed because this had been managed by another device before, one of my old controllers. So I can just remove that from the setup, and then I can choose to add the unit again because it's visible. And we can do all the types of things. We can go into those access points, we can upgrade them as you can see, we can change the different features on them. Again, we can then use, I continue on here, hopefully you'll be able to see, I just want to follow through the process that's running there on the screen beside me so you can see what we've gone through and done. We can then use that main screen that we have to get a feeling for what's actually happening on a network. We can look on our topology when we click on our topology, we get a basic idea of what devices are connected. We can go up to those lines at the top right hand corner and we can turn on some of the additional features like show wired clients and show wireless clients and our link speed. And now we've got more useful information to see what devices are connecting, how they're connecting, and we can drill down and get a whole load more useful information. The UniFi Express is a superb tool. If you're new to Ubiquiti, you're wanting to get a controller, an access point, and a router all in one, this is a really great starting point. For many homes, and maybe even some small businesses, you're probably not going to have more than a total of five Ubiquiti devices. So this makes it really super easy to get that set up. So maybe you're going to take one of these, use it as your router and your first wireless access point, You're going to take the LAN in here, and you're going to get a Ubiquiti switch to go with it. Let the camera fade. You're going to get a Ubiquiti switch, maybe like the USW Lite 8, which is a 8-port switch with 4 ports of PoE, and plug that in. And now we can plug in some of our other devices. Maybe you've got your printers and other things can be added into that, or some other wireless access points from Ubiquiti. And they can then be all managed from this. You have some basic features in here for intrusion prevention and application awareness. So you can see those different applications and some you can block, and some basic web content filtering policy control as well. They are really simple to use, easy devices. There are some other features in here that Ubiquiti have got for VPN and SD-WAN. They're probably not so relevant, and this is a small, lower performance unit, so you're not going to get enterprise grade performance out of this, but in a small shop that you want to connect back to a main network, this could be a good alternative. Remember, these can all be centrally managed. So what are the key takeaways? This has an access point in it, a router, and the controller. It can control 5 devices. We can mesh these together so that they can do that without, so the same SSID, but without cables between them. And you can just remember that when you do that, you lose physically half the speed. So if you start with 300 meg here, you'll generally only get about 150 meg here. So you wanna just make sure that that's faster than your internet connection. I suggest you don't put them more than about 10 meters apart. All right, to spread it out, we can run these as access points in our network. So you could connect this directly to a normal Ubiquiti network that you already have. And this could become a wired access point. As you go through the add process, it asks you what you want it to be. You can have this as a mesh to your current Ubiquiti UniFi network. So if you've got some U6 Pros in your house or property, you can now add this as a wireless device to it. You can then use it as a downlink. So it will mesh to that device, and then you could connect onto a switch or a physically wired device as well. So this gives you so many alternatives if you're new to Ubiquiti to get simply in, start using the ecosystem, add some of these features together for a great cost point. So if you're looking to do mesh through your property, a great solution. Looking to add some Ubiquiti access points, or we're looking for an entry-level router, this could be your good starting point for Ubiquiti with the controller. So I do hope that's been useful. What do I need to run Unifi Express? There are plenty of other videos that we've done on full configuration. This is the configuration of this, and the use of it is very similar to the UDM and the UDR. So do have a look at those videos if you want to. But really just bear in mind that this now opens up a whole new field of things that you can do for a great cost point, and build a solution that fits where you maybe need some devices mesh in your property, some physically wired, but you want to have that controller so you can do guest nest networks and other bits and pieces directly from it. So hopefully that's been useful. Why don't you look at some of the other videos we've got on our YouTube channel, subscribe and stay up to date.